Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry, and we are doing the topic plus R effect and minus R effect. Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about the resonance, and yes, we have also studied the phenomenon of the resonance by taking the example. In that case, we have got to know that the resonance means the delocalization of electron. But now we are approaching towards a new topic, that is plus R effect and minus R effect. So this is very related to resonance, but let us talk about it individually. So now we are going to talk about the plus R effect and minus R effect. So let us understand what is plus R effect. So when the transfer of electrons is away from an atom or substituent group attached to the conjugated system, it is termed as positive resonance effect, or we could call it as plus R effect. So let me talk about this thing with the help of an example. So the example can be written as, so this is an aniline molecule that I have represented over here, and because we are talking about plus R effect means the delocalization of electron, or we could say that the transfer of electron that is away from the substituent, and in this case the substituent is the NH2. So this NH2 group has been associated to the conjugated system, that is the benzene molecule that we could see over here. And talking about the next thing, that is the electron transfer will be away from this substituent. The reason behind that is because the nitrogen is the one that consists of lone pair of electron. These are the two electrons that you could see over here. So now the delocalization would take place in such a manner that and since we have also did that is representation of the electron movement, so in this case what will happen is these two electrons will be forming a bond between the nitrogen and the carbon over here, and meanwhile these two electrons that are of the two different carbon atoms, and they will jump on to this carbon atom. So that is the reason that we could get a product which is or we could get a structure which is like this one, as we could draw over here. So in this case there is a formation of a double bond over here, so therefore I would write it over here as N double bond NH2. Meanwhile, because the double bond, this electrons has formed a double bond, and meanwhile the nitrogen is the one which is forming basically a tetravalent, or the four, it forms four bonds. So nitrogen doesn't form four bonds usually, and that's the reason that it will have here as a positive charge. But meanwhile, if you could see that these two electrons are being shifted to this carbon atom, so making this carbon atom to be negative. So that's the reason I'm writing here as negative charge. And meanwhile, the other two pi electrons, they are in their own position, so therefore I would write it here as this one. But this is not a stable structure. Obviously that there would be another shifting of electrons or delocalization of electrons that we are that we had talked about in resonance. So that's the reason that we could see that this minus charge, or the one which acquires a lone pair of electron, that will be deposited on between these two carbon atoms, and the reason that these two electrons, they will shift on this carbon atom, making the structure to be, that is this is the one that will form a bond over here. Meanwhile, this two electrons has been shifted on this carbon atom, making this carbon atom to be negative, while this one will have a bond over here, and again there is a bond over here which was been present earlier, but it was not been affected by the resonance till yet. And there is double bond NH2 that we could see having a positive charge. Meanwhile, the another resonance is also what we could see is the structure, and these are the resonating structure that I am drawing, and we could see that these two electrons that are being present in the between these two carbon atoms, they will shift on this carbon atom. And meanwhile, this will shift this lone pair of electron towards this nitrogen, making this to be having a structure, as we could see over here, as this one. That is, it will have a bond over here. So it was already as it is. And meanwhile, we could see this even this will deposit over this case. So therefore, there will be formation of double bond over here, and the electron will get deposited on this carbon atom, and meanwhile it will be as it is just for a while. Suppose if I'm explaining this one, so now again this is not a stable structure, so what will happen is this electron will deposit on between these two carbon atoms, and this one which was having a positive charge, that will get fulfilled with the lone pair of electrons. And now the structure that we have got is basically, it is the one which has, and this is the structure that we have. And this is what the resonance that I was talking about, but this was a positive resonance that I was talking about. The reason behind that is because the lone pair of electron, or the electron that was being transferring, it was moving away from the substrate, and in this case the substrate was NH2 group. And since the reason, and since because of which, we could see the resonating structure, as you could see over here. And that is the thing. And talking about the hybrid structure, and the hybrid structure, it would be, that would be very much similar to everything that would give the every property of the molecule, and that's the reason that we represented by this dotted lines. And here it is NH2. So this is what I was talking about, the positive resonance effect or plus R effect. So now this has been done, and let us move on to the next one that we had an approach for, that is negative R effect. And what is that? Let me explain you that also. So now let us talk about what is minus R effect. So it is nothing but when the transfer of the electrons is towards the atom or the substituent group attached to the conjugated system, it is termed as negative resonance effect. So, or we could also call it as minus R effect. So let me give you an example in this case also, so as we could understand that what is actually minus R effect. So suppose this is a structure that I have mentioned over here, that is a conjugated system. For example, I would consider a benzene, and in this case basically a group that has been attached like this one. So this is the nitro group that has been attached over here, and what we have to do is we have to shift the electrons but towards the atom or towards the group that has been attached to this conjugated system. So now this oxygen consists of lone pair of electrons, as we know, and making this oxygen to be more electronegative. And so that's the reason that electron shifting would take place in such a manner that this two electrons that are, because of one of the electron is of oxygen and one of the electron is of nitrogen, that would be shifted towards the oxygen atom. And so as to fulfill this thing, what we could say that these two electrons will also be shifted towards this nitrogen atom. So as we could see that the shifting of electron would take place between the nitrogen and the carbon. So therefore the resultant structure that we could get is, because it is the thing that we are talking about, the resonating structure, so therefore a resonating structure would be formed over this case. In this case, these two electrons are in their position as it is, so there is no delocalization of electron till yet. And meanwhile, this one will form a double bond, and this one will have N, and this one will have O. And because of the two electrons are being shifted on this oxygen, so therefore this one would be negative. But meanwhile, if you could say that since the electron has been moved to, so as to form a double bond between nitrogen and carbon over here, so therefore this one would be the one which is, which will form positive charge. So that is what I would write over here. So this is I have discussed over here. So now, so as to stabilize this one, what we have to do is we have to, that is we have to shift the electrons. And so meanwhile, suppose if the electrons have been shifted off this one, so we could see that the positive charge would be acquired over this one or this one. So that's the reason that we could see that again the resonating structure would be occurred over here, and again there is there will be formation of double bond over here, and meanwhile the positive charge will be on this carbon atom. So this carbon atom was as it is, so I will keep it as it is. And talking about this one, even this nitrogen is forming four bonds, so again this one would be the positive one. So talking about the next one, that is this one would be as it is. So again the shifting of these two electrons will be on this carbon atom because of, to neutralize this positive charge. So meanwhile, suppose if this electron or these two electrons, suppose if they are deposited on between these two carbon atoms, we could see, we could see a resonating structure, that is where we could find a double bond over here. So this was the one as it is, but this is the new bond that has been formed over here. Meanwhile this one will have a positive charge, while the above one, that would be as it is. I have to mention this one has a negative charge, so therefore this is N, and I've written it as O minus. And so as to stabilize this one, obviously that this bond would form between this two, and even this would approach here. So therefore, the structure that we have got finally after resonating or after the delocalization of electron will be the double bond would be over here. Even the double bond would be here, and the double bond would be here. And meanwhile, this one will be carbon nitrogen single bond, oxygen over here, and this is the formation of double bond that we could see over here. So this is the similar structure to that of the earlier one, but this is not the resonating structure. This all are the resonating structure that you could see over here. And meanwhile, we could also draw the hybrid structure of this one. So the difference between the plus R effect and minus R effect is I would show you in this case. As you could see that the negative charge are present on the ortho position or in the para position, making this group to be group will have an attachment of the that is electrophile. And that's the reason that electrophilic substitution will take place on this ortho position or else para position, and again on the ortho position. But meanwhile, when you are talking about a molecule that is showing a minus R effect, so these are the positive charge that has been showcased in the plus ortho position and in the para position. Meanwhile, when we are talking about the electrophile, so electrophilic that is electrophilic reaction would take place or substitution would take place on the meta position because of the electron density is comparatively more than that of the ortho and then that of the para. So therefore, when it comes to electrophilic substitution for a group which is showing that is a plus R effect, then it would be occurring at ortho and at para. But when it comes to a minus R effect, it will the electrophilic substitution will take place on the meta position. So therefore, it also decides the reactivity of a particular substance and based on the substitution. And that is what I wanted to talk about. So this is what the plus R effect and minus R effect was with an example that I have showcased for you. So there are many other things that we could also mention for the one which is plus R effect and the one which is minus R effect, but this was a few examples that I wanted to showcase. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood this video very clearly. So I hope you will share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.